The IoTSuite.com website is basically a landing page for you to discover Azure IoT. And what we call the provision solutions are things that are already deployed on my account, but what I can do is actually create a new solution. Let me actually drive you through the process. On that web page, what I do is just like ask for a new solution to be created. I have several options for these new solutions. The first one is remote monitoring. We have a new version, which is in preview right now. This is the one I'm going to go through. I can eventually deploy a connected factory solution. So these are some of the examples of pre-configured solutions that will help me get started and discover what Azure IoT has to offer. So looking at the remote monitoring one, I will be able to select a few things about what kind of solution, basic or standard, allowing me to whether having something that is actually a single instance of that service, better fitted for evaluation and so forth, or a standard, which is actually a production version of that solution. My backend is developed with code, so I can pick .NET, Java. As an exec, I don't care right now. What I can do is actually then create that Contoso solution, HVAC service solution. I can pick one of my Azure subscriptions, so I need to have a subscription to work on that, and then I can pick the region I want to deploy that solution onto. So the actual regions that are available are these ones listed. So let me actually go to East US. And from here, what I can do is just like create solution. And it's going to take something that like 5-7 minutes to deploy a full-blown solution for IoT with many services that I'm going to describe a little here. But for now, you've noticed I've not touched code. I've not done anything but just clicking on a few buttons here. So this is exactly the solution that would have been deployed if I had clicked continue on that previous page. But here's what I get by deploying that remote monitoring solution. I get a full-blown dashboard that monitors devices across the world. And these devices basically are sending telemetry data to Azure. That data is analyzed by various types of services. And I gather all that data and that process data, and I display that in a dashboard. And the dashboard shows me the location of the devices because they've been sending metadata when connecting. It shows me various alerts that have been setting up. And it allows me to dive into KPIs that I can track to make sure that I have all my devices in good health and that eventually I've been dealing with the alerts and so forth in a timely manner. On the devices page, I can see all these devices. So here we have some number, but because they can be way more, I can also filter them. I can create filters. I can then pick, for example, only the chillers and filter the view here. And I'm able to monitor more closely what's going on into my system. So me, remember, I'm an exec. I'm looking at that as, well, what is possible with Azure IoT Suite? And I'm discovering all of that. I'm saying, hey, it's pretty straightforward and easy. Let me actually select some of these guys here. What can I do? I can schedule maintenance. That's interesting. I can eventually do a firmware update. Awesome. So basically, I can see that from that dashboard, I have a full control over things all the way down to firmware update over the air. That's pretty interesting and cool. There's that maintenance tab as well, which is something I want to dive into a little. That's where basically I will have my maintenance operator do its maintenance. And what can I discover in there? I can see that we have an alert here. So I can actually visualize that alert. I can dive into the history for that alert. I can also try and understand what is that rule that has been triggering that alert. And I realize that the trigger basically has been that pressure went over a certain value. So this is very interesting here in terms of me being able to have the history of the alerts and then dive into these various types of information that are up there. In terms of the telemetry data, actually, I can also dive into each of these devices. So back to that device view, I can actually visualize real-time data for temperature, for humidity, for pressure. And I can also see the various methods that are available. So how can I control and configure these devices? I'm actually using simulated devices because I've not deployed any real device, but this is something that actually allows me to visualize what's possible. I can also go all the way down to the raw telemetry messages that are arriving. And you'll see that this actually view shows that these are updating in real time. So this is pretty interesting and insightful here. So at this stage, I think as an exec, I've been able to discover at a high level what are the capabilities, which is gathering data from devices, having some rich analytics configured from a very simple dashboard, and then being able to connect that to a workflow through the alerts that have been triggered, such as my ERP or any sort of line of business application. So I'm ready to actually prepare the requirements for my dev team to go and start customizing that IoT suite solution and play around with Azure IoT.